Deno 1.38 is out, and we are continuing our efforts to constantly improve the platform while simplifying your dev experience. Here are the highlights of this new release. How often do you think about proper code documentation? Don't answer, we know it's not one of your priorities. However, documentation is an important aspect in any large production project, and we are happy to handle it for you. This release adds the new deno.doc.html command, which allows you to generate a static documentation site for your project, making it easier than ever to share insights with your team or broadcast them on the web. Next, in this new release, we are introducing another big quality of life improvement, hot module replacement. This is a common feature in JavaScript development that allows you to update and replace modules in an application without requiring a full page refresh or a complete application restart. You can try it out using this command, which works exactly like the watch flag, but instead of restarting the process, it attempts to patch the files in place. As always, we are continuing to improve the Node.js compatibility. With this release, you can now use Deno with the NPM package manager of your choice. Here we use NPM to install a package. Let's update our Deno.json. Then, we run the simple main.ts file. Deno can successfully run the project even when we use NPM to install Node modules. This feature greatly increases the compatibility of Deno with the NPM ecosystem, such as making it easier to use Deno in existing Node codebases. Give it a shot and let us know what you think. This release introduces a new JSX transform that is optimized for server-side rendering. It works by serializing the HTML parts of a JSX template into static string arrays at compile time. This is more efficient than creating hundreds of short-lived objects, which lean quite heavily on the garbage collector. In our testing, we observed around 7 to 20 times faster rendering times and a 50% reduction in garbage collection times. The more HTML parts the JSX has, the greater the speedup. For components, however, we'll fall back to the traditional JSX transform internally. As always, this release contains a handful of other updates, ranging from WebSocket improvements to API changes, and you can read more details about all these in the description. Until next time, thank you for watching.